Meet the other tight end from the state of Florida. Brevin Jordan out of Miami might not have had the eye-popping stats, but he was a consistent contributor throughout his 3 years in college. Miami flexed him all over the field, and he projects well as a move tight end in the NFL with the ability to work inline, in the slot, outside, and as a sniffer in the backfield. He's not a blazer with a 4.6 40 time, but he uses good route technique and is a tenacious blocker wherever he's lined up. Brevin Jordan brings intensity and competitiveness to his blocking assignments. Regardless of whether he's working on a defensive end, linebacker, or a corner, he blocks with an edge. If he gets a good fit, defenders really struggle to shed and disengage. He could use a little bit more strength in his lower body at times, but he does a good job of keeping his base and does a fantastic job outside, taking on some more difficult blocks in space. Especially for larger guys, blocking outside and on the perimeter can be a challenge when facing shiftier defensive backs. Jordan was a plus player when asked to block on bubbles and did a really impressive job not only attaching onto those blocks, but finding ways to sustain and finish those blocks as well. He consistently got good fits with inside hand position and fought to stay low and in front of his guy. He was used much less frequently as an inline guy for Miami, and they asked him mostly to work combos and down blocks so he could climb and get to the second level. He sometimes struggled to move defensive ends and linemen, but was a clear winner on second level defenders via kickout blocks or when he worked off of those combos. Where he did have a couple bad reps was in pass protection. Here, Miami is running a full line slide to the right with the intention of leaving their running back on the end man on the line of scrimmage to the left. However, Jordan doesn't slide to protect against the linebacker shooting in off of that slide. He hinges to protect against the end, but leaves too much space and a gap in the protection. Knowing that the running back is coming over to help take the end, Jordan needs to take away the inside rush first and confirm that the linebacker is dropping before he kicks out to take the end. He realizes that mistake a little bit too late and is caught in no man's land, which results in the pass rush getting home. Despite some issues in pass pro, Jordan's ability blocking tight to the formation allows him to be used off of play action on crunch blocks to the flat to get him on the move and in space. To really be able to perform at the next level, he has to continue to grow in his ability to block and hold up when he's lined up in line. Brevin Jordan doesn't need to just be schemed open though. He doesn't have fantastic straight line speed and can struggle with contested catches, but he does utilize pretty polished route running to win and create separation for himself. That's incredibly valuable when he's split out at the slot and away from the formation. One of the best parts of his game is understanding the coverage and defense he's facing and using route technique to make sure he ends up in open space. UNC is giving a too high shell with a lock call to the top of the screen by the corner, and the corner to the bottom of the screen is playing flats in cover two. That defense essentially isolates Brevin Jordan on the safety. Miami has a smash concept dialed up, and the hook and the corner to the bottom of the screen occupies the field safety, and Jordan knows that all he has to do is widen the boundary safety and win inside leverage after clearing the linebacker. At the top of his route, Jordan begins to lean and stem the safety outside until they turn their hips. As soon as those hips turn, Jordan plants, snaps his head, and bursts to the middle of the field where he's cleared the linebacker and is wide open with inside leverage. Jordan has efficient footwork, uses his hands and his routes well, and knows how to attack defenders. He's especially deadly on seams and posts where he can win leverage and use his route stems to create more space for himself. He's got size and athleticism, but that didn't show up on contested catches. He had some drop problems and routinely lost tight window throws where he has to box out and use his frame to win the ball. That's really his biggest hurdle as a pure receiver because the football IQ and understanding are definitely there. He just isn't a very confident hands catcher, and while he displayed the ability to attack the ball away from his frame at times, it just wasn't consistent enough to give you a ton of confidence. He'd often let balls get into his chest and allow for defenders to close space on him. He's not always going to run away from people or run through people, but he does display some athleticism and isn't a total liability in space. If you give him room to work with, he's good enough to take the yards and make someone miss on occasion. Brevin Jordan has the route running polish to be a nice weapon in the NFL. He has the flexibility to move all over the field, and with a team that can use him creatively, he can be a force down the seam and as a blocker on the perimeter. With a little bit more technical work and strength, he could quickly ascend to being one of the best value picks in the draft.